Hey racers, John Racer with you today, back for another showcase video. Today I'm going to be showcasing my top 10 favorite super treasure hunts in my collection for you guys. I don't think I've ever showcased my super treasure hunts like ever, so this is going to be a really fun video because super treasure hunts are something that I love, that Hot Wheels makes. I never really find them. I'll get into that later in the video, but these are some absolutely beautiful cars. So I'm going to start off with my number 10, and that is the 2010 Ford Shelby GT500 Super Snake in green. Now, a little bit of backstory behind the Super Treasure Hunt. When I first started my channel, if you look back, I did a whole bunch of eBay videos where I just showed off my haul of cars that I would buy off of eBay, and this was surprisingly one of them. I bought this thing, I think I bought this thing loose on eBay. It was probably 2015 when I bought this car, so it was one of my first Super Treasure Hunts ever, and it just looks so good. The color combination on this thing, you got the dark green with the golden rims, especially those wheels there look super good. And it's just sort of like a nostalgia factor for me, this car, since I've had it since pretty much the very beginning of my channel. I'm pretty sure you can find a video of me opening an eBay package way back when with this car in it, which is absolutely mind-blowing to me, and it's still one of my top 10 favorite super treasure hunts of all time at number 10. So I absolutely adore this car. Now at number 9 we have a Toyota off-road truck. I do not remember what year this Toyota off-road truck came out. I do kind of want to say 2015 or 2016. I think it was a 2015 car in 48. It came out with the same deco as well as like a Toyota Corolla and a Toyota Supra. I believe it had the same sort of red paint scheme on it, but this was actually a gift to me from my friend the Not So Completionist over there on YouTube for a birthday. I don't remember how old I was, but this was still one of my like first super treasure hunts that I got, and I just love the Toyota off-road truck as a casting. So for it to be a super treasure hunt not only once but twice, I have the other one but it's not unboxed yet. These are only my favorite unboxed supers, and this car is just absolutely amazing. You don't see many Hot Wheels with very big rubber off-roady type wheels. So that is at number 9 on my top favorite super treasure hunts. At number 8, we have a very special Porsche 934.5 with that number 34 there in blue. Now, if you've been on my channel for a while, you guys would remember a vlog or an in-store video that I did where I found this Porsche. It was actually the special Target event that Target hosted like a year or two ago, where collectors would go and then open cases, and they had like a whole bunch of activities. I have the vlog on my channel. I'll link it down below if I remember to. But I actually found this thing in a brand new shipper. So this is actually one of the only supers that I have personally found. So where I live, it's a very contested place for collectors, so they can't really find like a whole bunch of super treasure hunts and stuff, because people always just go to like Walmart or Target and then get the cases right as they're shipped in. Sadly, I do not have that privilege, so it's very difficult for me to find super treasure hunts. So most of these super treasure hunts that I have, I did not find in a store, and I either bought at a Matchbox convention or on the internet. But this car I did find in person, and it is an absolute beauty of a car. I love the paint, I love the wheels, and it's a great casting to have a super treasure hunt as well. Coming up at number 7, we have the Golf Indy Oval car. Now, I do believe I found this as well at a K-Day. If some of you guys, it's really sad that you guys don't even know what a K-Day is. K-Day, it used to be this event at Kmart. I think it's still a thing that you could go to your Kmart every February, September, and November, and there would be a collector's event. You could open a case, have a chance of finding a super, and I found this at my very last K-Day, surprisingly, in my case, and it's a really nice casting. I love the Golf castings. I can't wait for the 4GT Golf Super Treasure Hunt to come out here soon, so I'm super excited to get that. But this Golf livery Indy Oval car is very good looking, and it's very fast too, surprisingly. A lot of super treasure hunts, since they have rubber wheels, really aren't that fast on the track, but this thing, it's got some slicks on it. As you can see, it doesn't have any treads, and this car is extremely fast and extremely good looking. I love it. It is at number 7, I believe. Now Number six. This thing is absolute beauty of a car. We got the Lamborghini Miura Homage, or the Lamborghini Aventador, whatever you want to call it, in that red Spectra Flame paint. This thing is an absolute beauty. I've been wanting this car ever since it came out, and I just recently got it at the most recent Matchbox convention, and I have to say it is an absolutely beautiful car. Even like the main line, the paint scheme and like all of the color palettes that they used on this thing just works so well on the Aventador. It looks so good, and I cannot wait to do more videos with this. I want to make more videos about my Super Treasure Hunt collection, but I don't know what to do. Comment down below if you have a video idea for the Super Treasure Hunt collection. Now, we are at the top five. These top five cars have a little bit more of a backstory to them, especially number five. We have a 37 Ford. Now, you guys might be asking, John, what the heck? What is this 37 Ford Super Treasure Hunt here? Is it even a Super Treasure Hunt? I don't even remember this thing. And this was a Super Treasure Hunt back in, I want to say, 2007, or around that sort of time frame that this car came out. Now, this is when Hot Wheels still did their Super Treasure Hunts differently, where there would be a mainline version, which is good, which would be the regular Treasure Hunt, and then there would be the super version with rubber wheels. So this car did also come out as a regular Treasure Hunt, just with like regular paint and regular wheels. But this thing, it caught my eye at the most recent Matchbox convention, and I'm like, oh my gosh, this car looks so incredibly good with the red wheels and the white wall tires, and then the blue Spectra Flame paint and the wooden like decals on the back and side and top. And I'm like, oh my gosh, this thing looks incredible. I cannot believe that Hot Wheels has made this car, and it's something I know a lot of people don't really care about because it's not a supercar or a hypercar, but I think it just looks so good in person. I mean, it might not come across on camera, but in person, this car is probably one of my favorite, if not the all-time favorite Super Treasure Hunt in my collection. But it's going to stay at number five, because at number four, we have the Ford GT Super Treasure Hunt. Now, this was a very unique casting, because when this Ford GT came out, it was actually a brand new model. I want to say it was 2017 that this car came out. I could be correct on that, but I did get it for a birthday gift. I think from my brother, actually gave me this Ford GT Super Treasure Hunt. And the Ford GT is one of my favorite castings that Hot Wheels has made. It was one of those castings that when it came out that year, it was like the star casting. Like for this year, you had like the Bugatti Chiron, the Vulcan, you had all of those brand new castings that everyone was going crazy for. This was the model that I was going crazy for back in 2016 as a Super Treasure Hunt. It might have been 2017. I do not remember the years of the Super Treasure Hunts that well, because I'm getting very mixed up, because I know way too many Hot Wheels going through my head from what years they're in and stuff like that. But it's pretty much just like the regular car that came out in a darker blue Spectra Flame paint, in those gray wheels, rocking them very well. Very nice looking Ford GT Treasure Hunt there. Absolutely love it. Now, coming in at number three, we have, wait for it, the Plymouth Superbird. This was also a Super Treasure Hunt that I found at K-Day. Well, funny story, I didn't actually find this at a K-Day. The way K-Day worked is if you got a ticket, you could open a case. So obviously my parents would help me drive there and they would get tickets as well. So we couldn't go up twice, but my parents, if we both got cases and their ticket was called, they would go up and say, hey, what cars should I look for? And surprisingly, my mom pulled this Super Treasure Hunt out from a case, and it is by far one of my best Super Treasure Hunts in my collection. Like, this is a pretty valuable super as of now, I think. It's been a while. I haven't like seen any of them on Instagram or online or anything like that. So I think they're pretty valuable, and it's just, there's so much like nostalgia and like memories that go along with this car. I remember like the time when I unboxed it, what I was doing, what I was filming. This was at the very, very beginning of my channel as well. All of those old videos, I like to go back and watch them sometimes, but you guys don't have to do that. Very cringy stuff. But the red wheels on this thing, the Super Treasure Hunt logo, the 33 T-Hunt Racing as a sponsor, I mean, it doesn't get much better than that. That is definitely one of my favorite Super Treasure Hunts in my collection. Absolutely beautiful. Now, coming in at number two, Should be no surprise to you guys. You guys know I'm a Ferrari collecting fanatic. We have the Ferrari 599 XX Super Treasure Hunt in black. Now this thing is absolute beauty. It's one of my gems in my collection. I don't know where I'd be in my collection without this car, because when I started collecting, this was one of the cars I'm like, okay, I will have to eventually get my hands on this thing, because oh my gosh, is it valuable. I mean, since this was the last Super Treasure Hunt Ferrari made before they lost their license with Hot Wheels, so that just makes it even more valuable. And just like the black paint and the red wheels, the red accents and everything, and it makes the car look so good. Hot Wheels did such a good job with the 599XX cast, and you guys know that from the previous video I made about hypercars, but even the main lines look good for these cars. It's absolutely insane. But that is my number two pick, the Ferrari 599XX in red and black. Absolutely beautiful. Now, coming in at number one, you guys should probably already guess what this car is. It's another Ferrari 599XX Super Treasure Hunt, but this time it is in red. Now, a lot of people don't know this car actually exists. This car came out in, I want to say, 2012, 2011-ish. I could definitely be wrong about that, but this car, it's a lot more valuable than the black one, because since it came out earlier, people did not know the Ferrari license was going to, like, terminate at that point, so they just went ham, and then these things got, people didn't collect them as much, like, for the value that they're at now, I guess I could say. But I'm so glad I got my hands on these. Both of the Ferrari 599XX Super Treasure Hunts I got at the Matchbox convention, which I'm super lucky to be able to have the opportunity to go to, because I'm able to get all of those cars that I've wanted for my collection forever. And if you guys watch my channel trailer, this car is one of the star cars, because it's one of my favorite cars of all time, I have to say. Absolutely beautiful looking car there. So that is my number one. Now I should do some honorable mentions. I only showed you my top 10 Super Treasure Hunts that are unboxed. I still have some boxed Super Treasure Hunts that I think could seal the deal if I unbox them at some point. Like, we have the Audi RS6 Avant here. Now it's in a Protecto. I should have taken it out of the Protecto, but these cars I feel like could make the top 10 list once I unbox them. I'll unbox them for some sort of special occasion at some point. And this one is even, it says factory sealed, as you can see. It's from the 2018 set. It's an absolutely beautiful casting. I know my friend, the Not So Completionist, or aka Reed, has one of these, and it's one of his favorite Super Treasure Hunts. So I'll unbox that at some point. I think it'll be absolutely beautiful. Now, another casting that I think could make the list is the Ford Escort here, the Hot Wheels made super, super recently. I think this was also a 2018 casting, but this came out as just a regular Super, but then the Bone Shaker Super came out with the same, like, decals and stuff like that from Hot Wheels, because it was their 50th anniversary Super. And let me tell you, I love the Escort, and as it as a Super Treasure Hunt, I think it could definitely make the list. Now, one of my all-time favorite castings is this Greenwood Corvette. This came out in, I want to say, 2014, actually. My bad. This car came out in 2014. This was before I started collecting, but the Greenwood Corvette's one of my favorite castings of all time from Hot Wheels, so I'm glad to have this as a Super Treasure Hunt. It's definitely going to be up there when I unbox it. It's going to be probably top 5, top 6 even, from after I unbox that. Now, this final honorable mention is probably the most dear car in my collection of all time, and it is a Passing Gasser Super. Now, I'm gonna take this out of Protecto, because this car has a lot more sentimental value than I think any other car in my collection, because the story behind how I got this car is, it's crazy. So I went on vacation with my family to the Bahamas at one point, and I found this store that, it was the only store in the Bahamas that had Hot Wheels in it. So I'm like, wow, this is absolutely insane. I'm gonna go ahead, see what I can find at the store. And this thing was sitting right on top of the pegs. I mean, it was just sitting there. I guess no one in the Bahamas really collects Super Treasure Hunt, so I was super lucky to find this thing. This was my first ever Super Treasure Hunt find in the wild, as they say, and it wasn't even in my home country. And this thing, it's just, it has so many memories for me. As you can see, you got a little bit of a crease on the card there. You got the price sticker from what it was in the Bahamas. And I mean, I don't think I'm ever going to unbox this thing just because of the value that it has to it to me. I feel like, let's say in a hypothetical situation, my house were to burn down, this is the one car I would take because it represents, I feel like, what I do as a collector and what I stand for and all of the cars that I have. Because even though it's casting that you could sell for maybe $10, $15 on eBay, I don't think I'll ever sell this thing because it's a cool casting too, and it's a very memorable first Super Treasure Hunt to find, and I absolutely love it. So that is probably my all-time favorite Super Treasure Hunt, but it's not unboxed, so it didn't technically make the list. So there you guys have it. That is my top 10 Super Treasure Hunt collection video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Comment down below what cars you want to see me do next week. I'll listen to you guys' comments and then I'll post them. So comment down below and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take it easy. Peace.